is that I was going to be a hero for my children. I thought you and I had a bigger relationship, a better relationship than this. I'm sad that you stabbed me in the back. I'm sorry. Control what you can control. If you can't change your people, then guess what? You gotta shift and change your people. Here's a quick video here of me selling my car, saying goodbye to my Lexus GS300. Do you know why? Because I used the cash from that car and those things I just bought to buy my wife a ring for her finger. So it's that time of year again. It's the middle of summer. Something that we call here at the Seven Figure Squad, the season of distractions. See, this is the season where most everybody kicks back and relaxes. This is a season where some of the most highly talented and most proficient and efficient people take their foot off the gas. Again and again, year after year, it's these folks' inability to deploy this one skill that keeps them away from their dreams. So please stick with me in the next 20 minutes and I'll uncover and unpack the one skill that every millionaire masters in this episode of the Seven Figure Squad. Happening in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jada. Steady through the rigor. What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Zappala here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas. And as I said, in this episode, I'm going to be breaking down the one skill that every millionaire masters in order for them or you to become a first generation cash flow millionaire. But before we get going, please drop me your affirmation and put it in the comment section below stating, I am becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire. Put that in the comment section. But if you believe and you want to affirm that that is happening to you in your life. And again, to quickly remind you, our journey right now, crossing over 117,000 subs, is to get to 150,000 subs. Why? Because we want to award a church, charity, or nonprofit on behalf of you and the Seven Figure Squad YouTube channel, a $5,000 check from us to that church, charity, or nonprofit that we crowdsource and nominate to receive that money from us to them. So please help us cross 150,000 subs and subscribe below. Now, without further ado, let's get into today's episode. If you were with us last week, we uncovered three elements on how millionaires get things done. Quick refresher, number one, identify macro and micro goals. Number two, keep a scoreboard and or a leader's bulletin. And number three, accountability. Now we know that this three-step process works, but there's one variable that every first generation cash flow millionaire stumbles across and yet masters and crushes in their journey. And during the summertime, this one variable is amplified, especially with the typical summertime chaos of kids being out of school, family vacations, graduations, weddings, holidays, family barbecues, anniversaries, birthdays, and on and on and on. Now, these small distractions can pile up, especially when you add them on top of the current distractions you're already dealing with. And without mastering this one key skill set, you'll end up just like everybody else, falling short of your goal to becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire. So, what's this skill? Boom, processing issues. Now, in my time being coached and mentored by Patrick Bet-David, processing issues stands alone as the number one key skill set that helps people get closer and closer towards their dreams, or sadly, further and further away from their dreams. It either adds confidence to you or sadly takes away. Now, without this one key skill set, people can work and grind all week, all month, all quarter, half the year, all year, and look up and still say, wow, how come I got nothing to show for? I've been doing all this work and still I'm no more further ahead of my goals than I was last year. So how does one develop the skill set to process issues? So I'll break down five key areas for you to process issues quicker and faster. Number one, be big picture focused. What am I talking about? Don't let short-term setbacks derail you from your long-term goals. See, you gotta keep your eyes on the prize. See, Michael Jordan lost many times in his career playing basketball, but his vision was greater than one short loss, one loss of a season, one loss of a playoff. His vision was greater. He said, you know what? I'm here to play basketball. I love this game of basketball. I'm gonna win a championship. He kept his eyes on the prize. See, the thing about processing issues and dealing with distractions and conflicts and arguments is that you and I have a tendency to be emotional beings and creatures, and we have a tendency to overreact. Yes, you make a mountain out of a molehill. Some may even phrase that saying you are emotionally unstable. You see, here's a challenge with having your emotions high. When your emotions are high, logic and decision-making is low. And that's when the enemy, your competitors, get you. They get you out of position. They outthink you. They out-strategize you. They out-position you. And next thing you know, you lose out on opportunity. Why? Because you overreacted. Here's the bottom line when it comes to number one. You got to be more emotionally stable through a crisis. Now, I learned a lot through this in my 20s and early 30s. Why? I went through a divorce. I went through a bankruptcy. I became a single father. I was in family court. I was in bankruptcy court. Uncomfortable for me to be in that position, being challenged by a judge, still having to run a business and launch a business. There's a lot of crises and distractions coming my way. But one thing that stayed way ahead is that I was going to be a hero for my children. That I was going to provide a lifestyle for my kids that I never grew up with, that I only dreamed about. But I, if it was on my watch, I was going to put it on my shoulders, and all the pressure was on me to make sure I perform in spite of the crisis, that I win. And if that meant me to master my emotions, to calm down and still keep the main thing, to keep it down to four areas that helped me on a daily activity standpoint, to make sure I was monitoring my activities, to keep the main thing, to make sure I was in money-making activities, not money-making distractions, then I was still keeping my eye on the prize, and I had the opportunity to still pay my bills, to still get ahead financially and keep my distractions low. So if you want to affirm that you're keeping the big picture, please drop in the comment section below. I am focusing on the big picture. Put in the comment section below. Are you focused on the big picture? Put it in the comment section. I am focusing on the big picture. Number two, get over things quickly. Learn how to forgive quickly. Learn how to forgive quickly when an argument with a spouse, your business partners, your trolls online, other business partners and vendors, when they betray you, when they stab you in the back, when they reverse their promises on you. Because here's the bottom line. You can't control what other people do, but you can control your attitude. You can control how you respond to things. And sometimes we try to control other people, and sadly, that's called a manipulative activity. But you got to surrender and be able to say, you know what? You're going to do what you're going to do. I can't control you. Man, dog, I can't believe you're doing this. God bless you. I forgive you. I wish you well in your endeavors. More power to you. And mean that and take that and have that come out from you in a very sincere and genuine way. Don't make God bless you, don't make I forgive you sound like a cuss word in terms of the way you say things. Don't make things sound like you got an attitude behind it. Say, listen, man, I'm really sorry that you came out this way. I thought you and I had a bigger relationship, a better relationship than this. I'm sad that you stabbed me in the back. I'm sorry, I can't have you come back to the office. Your relationship is over in terms of business. I cannot trust somebody with my finance. I cannot trust somebody with my business that acts this way. But with that being said, don't let me be in your way of your journey towards success. But you can't just do it over here. You can't just have a situation where you're going to conduct this activity or this type of behavior in my office, in my business. I'm sorry, I have to let you go. We have to sever our business ties. I've got to fire you. I got to have other people fill your position because I can't look over my shoulder in the role that you're playing to get me to my next level. So with that being said, I wish you well in your next endeavors. More power to you. Pack your things. We got to go. We leave as friends. If I owe you any money, if I owe you last paycheck, here it is. And I wish you well. How many guys ever seen that movie Gremlins? Okay. How many guys were in love with Gizmo? Okay. What happened to Gizmo? What happened to Gremlins when they poured water on these creatures? They poured water on these creatures and they multiplied. See, that's what happens when you pour water or you add more attention and emotion to people that you know are gonna constantly stab you in the back if you pour water on it without cutting it off. Guess what they're gonna do? They're gonna multiply in your life. You're gonna have more anguish and grief and bitterness in your heart, in your spirit. You're paying the price for harboring that. And the people that you love and care about are now affected because you continue to pour water on these gremlins. It's in your capacity to forgive and move on. Let the number two position people, let the number three position people, let your competitors constantly troll you and do what they need to do. Let them keep focusing on you, but you need to focus back on number one. You need to focus since you're a leader, you're becoming a first generation cash flow millionaire. Focus quickly, go back to point number one, focus on the big picture. So if you affirm with me that you're going to forgive and let things go quickly and say to your baby, listen, if we're not arguing about this 5 years from now, why are we arguing 5 minutes from now? I forgive you. I love you. Let's move on. I'm staying with you. You and I are going to stay married. You're still my business partner. Whatever the case may be, you're still my son, my daughter. I love you. Bottom line is I love you no matter what. We're still going to get through this. We have a little bit of conflict right now. We're going to rise above it. I trust you. You're not violating any moral details in my life. You're not cheating on me. You're not stealing from me. You're not stabbing me in the back. Listen, I'm going to forgive you. This is a conflict. Let's move on. If you feel that way, go and put in the comment section below, I am forgiving those that do me wrong. Put in the comment section below if you believe you're going to forgive people quickly, sooner, faster than you have before. Point number three, avoid the blame game. Listen, the worst position to operate your business is you blame other people for your lack of success. You're blaming other people for your lack of progress. You're blaming other people because you are not in a position that you want to be in. The worst thing to do ever is to blame other people in situations and circumstances. You're acting as if you don't have any power or control to rise above certain situations. And you do. Here's the bottom line. Victims never, ever will win. Victims don't win. My friends, take 100% responsibility of your situation and control what you can control. If you're in a position of saying, I need to hire people for this position, you also have the capacity to say, you know what? I need to fire people because they're not the right person for that position. You can understand, professional sports teams, professional recruiters, professional placers of talent, they're always constantly scouting for new talent to fill certain positions. If this person isn't willing to step up and do the job, guess what? They need to be let go. You find someone else to fit in that position. You constantly find new talent to fit that position, new skill sets to fit that position. New people in that position or new people in your company is always a fresh breath of air. I mean, right now, everybody in Chicago, even though I'm in Dallas, but I'm still a Chicago Bears fan. Everybody in Chicago right now is so fired up about Justin Fields, the new quarterback that they just drafted from Ohio State. Everybody's excited about him. Now, there's a veteran that's been around for years. His name is Andy Dalton. They call him the Red Rocket. But he's a proven veteran. So how come people are more excited about the rookie that hasn't taken a snap in the NFL his entire life, who's still proving himself in training camp, and training camp has yet to begin? How come so many people are excited about him? Why? Because they're excited about his potential. They're excited about his upside. See, you need to be excited about the potential of yourself, the potential of your business, of the people, the team that you've assembled. If not, then you need to get rid of people, control what you can control. If you can't change your people, then guess what? You gotta shift and change your people. In other words, you gotta hire, fire new recruits. You must have the control in this position to make sure that if I can't win with you, I need to find somebody that will. You gotta keep in mind, every day is a hunt. As an entrepreneur, you wake up in the morning, it is a hunt. Otherwise, if you're not hunting for your success, you're just reducing your dreams and you're settling for the average and the ordinary and settling for mediocrity. Now, if you settle, you get run over by your issues, or you can rise above it, process it quickly, and move forward and become better because of it. Your choice. Now, for some of you faith-based people out there, you want to know a quick way to find your way to get closer relationship with God? Start a business. Oh, Lord, how do I handle the situation? Oh, Lord, how to handle this person? Oh, Lord, how to have this clientele? Oh, Lord, I'm fearful about this scenario. How do I get through it? Want to get closer to God? Start a business. Now, here's the thing with your relationship with God. My experience, I might be wrong on this, but if you come to God as a victim, you don't get very far. But if you come to God and say, listen, God, enable me, Lord. Help me with the skills that you want to use me as your vessel to get through the situation, because you want to see godly people elevate in the world of business. You want godly people to be elevated in the world of finance. How do you use me, Lord? Give me the wisdom necessary to get me through this situation. I want to trust you. Watch God working life for you. Those of you that are faith-based people out there. And one thing I've always appreciated, one thing I've always got fired up about, that in spite of circumstances, I always attached myself to something greater than just myself. When I was serving in the Marine Corps, listen, we loved our country, loved America. I love the brothers to left and to right of me. We are so selfless that we want to do more for our country. We want to do more for our unit. We don't want to do for our brothers and sisters in uniform than we do selfishly for ourselves. I don't know why we were wired that way. We were taught that way. Maybe it's the way they brainwashed us. But is it a bad thing that we surround ourselves and want to serve something greater than ourselves just individually? And you as an entrepreneur, you're there to serve people. You're there to help the community. You're there to help your people. You're here to provide solutions to a problem. Consider that you always are in a position to solve something greater than just yourself. So if you want to affirm this with me, so in the comment section, I'll put in there, I am blaming nobody for my situation. I am blaming nobody for my situation. All right, let's move on to number four. Have a short list. Have a short list for people that can handle my problems. A short list of technicians. A short list of vendors that can solve your situation. Finding somebody to do things like taxes that you can do yourself, but in order for you to get back time, you're gonna employ a tax preparer, a CPA, an enrolled agent. So therefore, you don't gotta deal with that paperwork. You make sure you hire somebody that's the higher skill set than you have at this present moment to do that for you. Those are things that help you buy back time and gives you the confidence knowing that things are done right the first time. Now, we did an interview with Rabbi Lappin, and even he said that there's importance to be dependent on others for small tasks like this because it forces us to need each other. And again, bottom line, you stay in your area of specialty and you save time. For example, my short list of people and technicians and assistants were in Chicago. I'm rebuilding that list here in Dallas. What am I talking about? Somebody here in Dallas that helps me with IT. Somebody in Dallas that helps me with a search for commercial real estate. Somebody in Dallas that helps me buy the cars I want to drive. Somebody here in Dallas that's somebody that helps me with cleaning the house, taking care of our children, landscaping, meal prep. So we're hiring people in their area of specialty. So therefore I stay in my specialty. And as an entrepreneur, I stay focused on building my business. I stay focused on serving our clientele and our agents and entrepreneurial business builders. I stay focused on the main thing. Back to point number one, I keep the main thing. I am big picture focused. If you say, Matt, listen, that makes sense. I need to have a short list too as well. Write down in the comment section with this affirmation. I am recruiting my short list of technicians. I am recruiting my short list of technicians. Let's move on to last but not least, point number five, embrace opportunities. You see, my friends, things don't happen to you. Things happen for you. Listen, as much as I want certain things to happen a certain way, you know what I've discovered in the last 22 years of being an entrepreneur? Things don't happen that way. You know, I've learned to and through my clients, they wanted things to happen a certain way. They want to have things evolve in a certain way that they were controlling, but certain things come in certain angles and wow, certain distractions come around and they're able to process these issues and say, you know what? What is God trying to tell me right here? What is my scenario? What is the universe? What is destiny trying to tell me in this present moment? What do I need to see? What am I overlooking? Because I'm so focused, I'm not looking up to see the opportunities that I need to embrace along the way. Now, here's the thing, we're getting through issues. I know you deal with challenges with health. I know you deal with challenges with children. I know the challenge you deal with was sadly a death in the family. Now, with that being said, take your time to mourn, take your time to process, take your time to deal with when life hits you with a low blow. With that being said, have a time, have a moment, have a deadline for you to look back up that you didn't take all month or all year to get through a distraction, that you looked up, you found the issue, you processed it, you identified it, you overcame it, and more importantly, you moved on. When my wife and I, we first got married, you guys gonna laugh at me, money smart guy. Yeah, when we got married, you know where I found myself? I found myself at the pawn shop. Now I'm Filipino, right? Getting rid of all my DJ equipment, getting rid of my TVs, my speakers. I sold my car. Here's a quick video here of me selling my car, saying goodbye to my Lexus GS300. Do you know why? Because I used the cash from that car and those things I just bought to buy my wife a ring for her finger and to invest in an event that's going to change our lives, to make sure that we adopt certain skills and behaviors and principles and values to help us run a business and a life and our finances for the long term. You know, the interesting thing, I ran a workshop the morning of our wedding. And people at my workshop said, listen, you're getting married today? Yeah, go, get out of here. Now, I was gonna be late to my wedding, but I had my priorities. Listen, if I want to make sure that there's romance in our life, I want to make sure that there's finance in our life. But after I get done with the workshop that morning, I got dressed in my tux, I got my beard shaven, and I went to the church. We got married. 3 days later, after we got married, we didn't go on a honeymoon. Where did we go? We went to an annual convention, we went to an event and a conference to learn more skills, to learn more things to better our financial future. Now, we didn't traditionally go to a honeymoon, but what have we been doing for the last 6 years? We've been winning. We put ourselves in a position where we're debt-free. We put ourselves in a position where we're financially free. We put ourselves in a position where we're taking care of our parents to retire those that we love and care about. That we're recruiting our family to come help us to work together with us in business, whether in our office or in our home. We are running our life the way we designed it and we want it to be. Of course, there are distractions along the way, but back to all this list. When distractions and issues come our way, we learn how to process it quickly and move on and move forward. So here's the thing about wealth building. The big thing about wealth building is anticipation, is anticipating when things can and will come up. What are we anticipating? We know there's gonna be a death in a family. We know there might potentially be a situation where I get into an accident and there's a will, there's a durable power of attorney, there's medical directives that I've written down. So therefore my wife doesn't have to make these difficult decisions for me, putting guilt on her. No, I've taken that out of her hands and put it under my control. I said, listen, this is what your husband wanted to do if I was put in that financial position. So therefore we can process this issue. My wife can process this issue. My children can process this issue and then move on. So ask yourself, what type of issues potentially may come your way? What type of distractions may come your way? Is it your ex-wife, your ex-husband, your children? A relative comes out the woodwork? Are you doing things right now that might create unnecessary tension your way? Anticipate those things, carve out those things, so therefore you can avoid unnecessary distractions. So here's the bottom line. If you have found your financial vehicle and you're in it, we want you to hit the foot on the gas and keep your foot on the gas and not let distractions hit the brake. Not let distractions and issues be in your windshield. We want issues and distractions in your rear view mirror getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. With that being said, if you understand that things happen for you and not to you, put in the comment section below this affirmation. I am embracing all opportunities. I am embracing all opportunities. As you exercise and develop and master this skill set of processing issues and managing distractions and confusion along the way, you will avoid what we call the start stop. You'll avoid what we call hitting speed bumps. You'll avoid having to restart momentum. As many of you know, momentum is one of the most jealous things you can have in your business life, because once you have momentum on your side, you want to make sure you dance with momentum on the dance floor, that you never get off the dance floor with momentum. If momentum is dancing with you, embrace momentum, harness momentum, and make sure momentum never leaves your side. Because when you do that, guess what starts happening to you? You're going to have a compounding effect of things happening well for you and good for you and fun for you over time. If you avoid the distractions and you allow your efforts to compound, guess what else compounds? Your income. Because the more you process issues and avoid distractions, the more then you can make money work for you. And I'll tell you this, it's a fun thing when money is coming your way and you have earned income, active income, passive income, portfolio income. It's fun to say, where do I need to put my money? Where can I have my money work for me? Instead of saying, oh my gosh, we don't have enough money. It's a completely different perspective to operate from. And these are things that help you become a first generation cash flow millionaire. If you found value with this episode, please subscribe. And again, the benefit of subscribing to our YouTube channel is helping us get to 150,000 subs, because we want to award a church, charity, or nonprofit that we crowdsource together that you nominate. And we're gonna give them $5,000 once we cross and reach 150,000 subs on the Seven Figure Squad YouTube channel. So please click subscribe. Before I let you go, check out these couple videos here. Number one is how millionaires get things done. I was mentioning it through the body of this episode. If you haven't watched it already, please check out this video. Now here's another video you should check out. Now that more people are starting to get more confident and comfortable being around other people, is one habit that every millionaire masters. Check out this video. With that being said, guys, if you haven't done so already, place your questions, your follow-ups, your questions, your feedback in the comments section below. If you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.